Hello, I'm Sars Tim. I will be sent the following applied research, investigating Hong Kong residents post-COVID-19 pandemic travel intention to India, applying the extended theory of planned behavior. First, I will talk about the background. Hong Kong's outbound tourism market has the remarkable characteristics and tremendous potential. This is the world's 11th and Asia's 3rd largest source market in terms of total international tourism expenditure. However, research on the outbound travel intention from Hong Kong is limited. And India has the diverse mix of art and culture, festivals, landscapes, spiritual beliefs, and tradition. But the country does not meet the expected number of tourist arrivals. Finally, the COVID-19 pandemic presents global community and tourism with the major and evolving challenge. Same, research regarding post-pandemic travel intention remains limited. Secondly, I will talk about the literature review. It has two sessions, Theory of Planned Behavior, TPB, and Perceived Risk. For the TPB, attitude means an individual's positive or negative assessments of conducting behavior. For the subjective realm, means an individual's social pressure when conducting behavior. For the persistent behavioral control, meaning an individual's perception of the ease or difficulty of performing the behavior of interest. For the travel intention, it means an individual's intent or commitment to travel. The second session is perceived risk. Financial risk means possibility regarding travel experience will not offer the value for money spent. And for the health risk, possibility regarding getting ill while at the destination or traveling. Finally, the physical risk, representing possibility regarding physical danger or injury harmful to health. The third part is research objectives. First, investigate the predictive force of attitude, subjective norm, and perceived behavioral control on Hong Kong residents post-COVID-19 pandemic travel intention to India. Second, examine the effects of perceived risk, financial, health, and physical risk correlated with Hong Kong residents post-COVID-19 pandemic travel intention to India. The fourth part is methodology. The sampling method is convenience sampling, which is easy access to research population. And the sampling size and population, there were 200 age 18 or above Hong Kong residents. Finally, for the instrument and data collection, it adopts the self-administrated online questionnaire using Dramovi, a free statistical software to data analysis. And it also adopts the descriptive statistics and regression analysis. The fourth part is the findings. First, I will talk about the demographic profile. For the gender, the respondents are distributed equally, which is 50% male and 50% female. For the age, the majority of respondents are 18 to 13 years old, which has 83 respondents, or 41%. For the educational attainment, the majority of respondents are getting a degree or above education attainment, which is 94 respondents, or 47%. Finally, for the marital status, most of the respondents are single. For the theory of planned behavior findings, first, for the travel intention, Hong Kong residents are not keen on traveling to India. And regarding the attitude, it has an impact on travel intention to India, which meaning that Hong Kong residents disagree with the positive attitude of traveling to India. Also, there are negative connotations with Hong Kong residents traveling to India. Regarding the subjective realm, it also has an impact on trouble intention as well, meaning that there has social pressure, which associates with former residents to disagree with traveling to India. Finally, for the perceived behavioral control, it has no impact on the travel intention to India, even though Hong Kong residents may have the necessary resources or opportunities to travel. If they do not have the travel intention, they may refrain from India traveling. For the perceived risk findings, both financial and physical risks have low impact on travel intention to India, while health risk has an impact on travel intention to India. It is important to note that the higher health risk, the lower travel intention. The sixth session is conclusion. This presentation enriches the literature on post-COVID-19 pandemic travel intention. Also, it helps destination marketing organization and travel trade industry to understand predictors of the post-COVID-19 travel intention to India. And the last part, the seventh part, is future research avenue. It leads to collect additional data driven by multiple queries, like post-pandemic recovery for longitudinal examination of issue, and includes more variables like destination image and travel constraint. And this is the references of the presentation. And that's the end of the presentation. Thank you for listening. Goodbye.